Malahat specializes in craft spirits, everything from their award-winning rums to bourbon and rye and vodka. So if you're ever in the San Diego area, come on down and check out Malahat. Well, today I'm super excited because I'm making a cocktail that I actually came up with myself. After all these years of drinking and cocktail making, you would think I would have my own signature drink. It's kind of about time. So, I came up with this drink actually as a spin-off of another favorite that I've become obsessed with, which is Frosé. So a few weeks ago, I was making Frosé with a friend of mine for my blog. So if you want the Frosé recipe, you can go to my blog. I will link it below. And we had leftover strawberry syrup. And I was going to just throw it away, but my wise friend was like, don't throw it away. It's good syrup. And I was like, okay, well, I don't know what I was going to do with it. But anyway, I get home. And I was like, what am I going to do with strawberry syrup? What am I going to do? I was like, ooh, I know. I'll do a cocktail. And I was like, ooh, I want something like vodka, and I want it to be sort of pretty and frilly and just foamy and delicious. And I was like, I know what I'm going to do. So that is when the Tickled Pink cocktail was born. And I hope you guys enjoy it because I do love it. And before berry season ends, definitely try to make this cocktail. And it is started with strawberry syrup. Now, if you don't have fresh strawberries, you can use frozen. I highly stress you use organic because you are steeping the strawberries in the syrup. But frozen or fresh, either will do. What I did was started off with a normal simple syrup, which is equal parts water and sugar. And then I threw whole strawberries in there and just let it steep for a half hour. You can just turn it off, let it go, and then come back, strain out the strawberries, and you have this beautiful pink syrup. So that's how you make a strawberry syrup. And now we can build our cocktail. So the cocktail starts with a shaker of ice. There we go. And then we have our simple syrup. And I use, again, now this could be done to your taste. So if you like a lot of sweetness, add more. If you like it less, add less. But I'm using about 1 ounce of simple syrup. Or strawberry syrup, I should say. So 1 ounce of that. And also, the longer you let your strawberries steep, the more red color you're going to get out of your syrup. So it'll make sure your cocktail's really nice and pink. After that, we are going to add 1 ounce of lemon juice. The lemon juice just brightens it up and kind of cuts through all the sweetness of the syrup. Oh, there we go. Come on, muscles. And we use 1 ounce of that. Fresh squeezed, as I always say, please buy the, don't buy juice, squeeze it yourself. Now, I'm going to use an ingredient that a lot of people may find a little off-putting and may not understand, but it makes sense in this cocktail. I'm using egg whites. Now, why am I using egg whites? Egg whites create a beautiful velvety foam on top of the cocktail, and it also gives the cocktail a really smooth mouthfeel. So when you have that astringent vodka paired with your egg white, it smooths it out and makes it really silky and beautiful. And trust me, you will not taste the egg. It is not going to be floppy and gross. It will be delicious. So please trust me on this one. Now, if you're allergic to eggs, please don't do this. If you are worried about raw eggs, you can buy pasteurized egg whites at the store. So use it or don't. It's not essential, but if you really want that beautiful foam and that great mouthfeel, I highly suggest you use the egg whites. So we're going to use 1 egg white. Now, 1 egg white is typically 1 ounce, so I'm just going to pour it in here. There we go. And now for the hard stuff, the vodka. We've got Malahat's own craft vodka that they make here from scratch. And we're going to use 3 ounces of vodka. So this may be a pretty pink drink, but it's a strong drink. So don't feel like you're wimping out by having this at all. And we've got our 3. That's 3 ounces. And now, the fun part, we shake it up. So, got my shaker. And now, shaking this cocktail is key for 2 reasons. It's going to chill it, but you have to shake it vigorously if you want to get that foamy egg white. So, shake, shake, shake. And this is where you just work on the gun shell. And I like to shake. thick until like, I can start to see that really pretty foam start to happen. And you can see it right there, all that foamy goodness. Now what I have here is a chilled cocktail coupe, and to chill your glass, you just add ice and water and leave it there while you make your cocktail, and that way it stays nice and chilled. So we're just gonna pull that out. I'm gonna get my strainer, and we are going to strain the beautiful Tickle Pink cocktail in its glass. Now check out that foam, check out that color. It's so pretty. And you can do a little heart in the foam as you twirl it around. And it is absolutely gorgeous. Now, just for a little dash of color, you can garnish with a pretty little strawberry, and you have a Tickle Pink. Like I said, it's beautiful, it's sophisticated, but it does pack a punch. I think this would be great for a girls' night, or just, you know, a fun cocktail hour. And I hope you give it a try and you love the Tickle Pink as much as I do. Let's see how it tastes. It's good. Cheers, everybody.